The most common cardiac congenital defect in the dog is PDA. The full name is patent ductus arteriosus. There's a vessel connecting between aorta and the pulmonary artery. So aorta and the pulmonary artery are two great vessels coming out of the heart. And there's an extra vessel connecting aorta and the pulmonary artery. That extra vessel is super important, is a normal structure during embryonic development in the fetal development. But after the birth, the vessel needs to be closed so that aorta and the pulmonary artery are not connecting, not shunting blood in between. However, in some dogs, after birth, that extra vessel is not closed, still sending blood from one part to the other part. That causes cardiac problems, and one of the most recognizable findings during our physical examination is to hear a continuous heart murmur. Normally, heart sound is going to be lopped up, lopped up, lopped up, lopped up. There shouldn't be any murmur or any abnormal sound in between heart sound. But in case of a continuous heart murmur, it sounds like like there's a continuous some noise going. Some people may say washing machine sound, but at the same time, it is very important to identify the exact right point to put the stethoscope on. In other words, when we listen to the dog's heart sound and heart murmur, oftentimes we only listen to one particular area in the heart, in the chest cavity, so-called the left apex. But in order to accurately detect the continuous murmur, we need to move the stethoscope to the left basilar area, which is underneath the armpit. If the stethoscope is not placed in the right place, sometimes this continuous murmur, which is really, really characteristic for PDA, can be easily missed. We recommend echocardiography to accurately confirming the diagnosis and also identify some cardiac structural changes and also functional changes, and also identify whether a patient is a good candidate for surgical intervention or not. Because some PDA dogs develop some concurrent cardiac problems such as congestive heart failure or pulmonary hypertension. In those cases, surgical intervention cannot be immediately pursued. We need to manage heart failure first. We need to manage the pulmonary hypertension first, then may be able to operate the patients to close the vessel out.